So I'm backing in, guys. I'm gonna got this ready to weld in. So I'm gonna try and start tacking in a few corners and get this squared up, because it's a bit sort of twisted with doing the bead rolls and stuff like that. So I'm gonna tap about it in here first, and then slowly get it all sort of sitting flat and sort of do a tack every 100 mil or so around here and just try and get it all squared up, get everything sitting properly before I actually fully weld it all. So that's what I'll do for a start off, so we'll get into it. Slowly getting there, people. Slowly getting there. Thank you.
Getting there. Hold. Underneath for a second and push that up a little bit. So easier to wear here and place with. All right now. We're getting there. I might just have to do a bit of hammer and dolly in to get it all to level out now and get all these extra bits into the right places. And we'll come back to you. Alrighty. Right, we've got this all but leveled up in a couple of little spots. I've got it tacked along here now and sort of squared up. There's a few high and low spots where I've still got to move up and down, but that's only just minor stuff, just a little bit of tweaking as I'm going along. So yeah, I can pretty much start routing along in a few of these places and getting a bit more in solid, and then we can just tidy up any other little areas which is going to be knocked down or lifted up or any other bits and pieces like that. What potentially here I actually probably should knock with the side for the grinder and actually just run a very grinding this cutter wheel along there and just leave that down a little bit. It's a little bit tight just in that one spot. I didn't realise underneath it was just sitting up a little bit prouder than I thought it was. What I'll do is I'll do some welds along here and get this edge locked in and a bit more locked in along here, and then I'll come back along here and I'll see if I can make this a little bit better and sink it down just a little bit further in. So we'll get to it and we'll do some more.
Getting there.
Again.
We're getting there. I'll stop the camera again and I'll just run and come along here and tidy this up. And now I'll try and dolly some of these extra bits and pieces just a bit closer together. Now I've got a few more holding spots. So we're about ready to, pretty sure we're about ready to almost do a full route at the weld around here. The majority of it anyway. Pretty good. Yeah. Trying to get the worst of it anyway.
Thank you.
Sweet. Yeah, a bit of a gap in this corner, unfortunately, but should be right, I can bridge that. That's pretty much tapped almost every inch from here all the way around to here. So I'll do a few more and then I'll turn the cameras off and I'll fully wind it off camera, otherwise you'll be sitting here watching 3 hours of footage. and not really, but you know what I mean. And the other thing I've got down here is I just temporarily fitted the accelerator pedal, which you can probably see there, and just double checking that's actually in the right place, so that's fully up and fully down. I know you can't actually see what's going on sort of a bit further in, but that fits good now, so it's all in the right position, which is a bonus. It even actually meets up with there's like a little wear pad on the back of the accelerator pedal, that white bit actually meets up with that pretty much spot on, fits good, so I've got that in the right place. So now that I've got that double checked, it's good, happy with that, so I can finish welding the rest of this now. And that was my boot lid that fell over before, if you heard that, with a bit of a gust of wind come through, and I had it leaning up against the side of the shed, and it must have just caught it enough to fucking flip it over. Fortunately, I haven't really done any body work to it, and I didn't do any major bloody damage, so, bonus. So we'll carry on here. I'll just got a little bit, if you can see that, I've got a little bit more just dolling in here, just to make this bit line up just a bit taller here, and we'll be ready to give this the full weld around. Once you get into it, you glue her in, and then it's tidying up time. And tying it off and popping the bottom, and then just have a look and see what other potential things I can fix. Because it has been sort of all patched up in here too, like with a joint. I think this is a piece of the original floor, if you can see that over here, behind the tunnel. So they sort of cut it and put a piece of another tunnel in, and then I think it's a piece of the original. They might have put back in there. I don't know whether it's the original piece that was in there, or whether it's a piece from another slightly different area, but looks like it's actually off the, because it's got the same like primer or prime sealer underneath it, so sort of that pinky sort of prime sealer that's sort of underneath all this paint on this car, like on the inside. So we're about ready. So yeah, then I'd like to try to get into some of these pieces and just see what I can potentially tidy up a bit better and make it look nicer, and we should be good. So it's good to have this. And sounds sort of nice and solid. Once I get it fully welded, it'll be even better. And it's good, so clean up then and seal it all up, and hopefully nobody will really know the difference too much once I've got it all ground up and tied it up and all the rest of it. Alrighty, do some more. Right, here you go, guys. Again, right, I've all but welded this in. There's bound to be the odd spot once I've ground it off, and because the gap was a bit big in here, the weld's a bit ugly. Just trying to build it up so I can get some decent weld across here. But where this piece here was, where it wasn't joint, very flat, I've just run the cutting disc up there and just separated that join, or cut that weld out, and flatten it off. So now I'll weld that up and make that a bit nice, bit more even. So that's pretty much it. I'm going to tidy up underneath and just tied up any other little welds and bits and pieces that I need to do when I go back over it and clean it all up. Now, the other thing I did too was it's a bit thin in here in places, just obviously from rust and stuff. So a little tip that I come found on YouTube, following somebody else's channel, that Bad Chad actually, he quite often, I don't know why he started doing it, but he did. He started using, this is a bit of old wire coat hanger. So I thought, shit, that's not a bad idea. Especially because I used it a little bit long here because where that gap was big. So I just used it so I could put a old dab in there while I was laying some weld in there. So I could actually hold it in there and put the MIG against it and weld a, you know, a decent dollop in there. And then I could actually weld around it. And I did the same here, whatever it's these thin spots. So basically I had the wire in the middle of the thin spot. It was being a bit rusty. And got the, you know, decent dollop to stay there. So it wasn't going to blow it away. And then I just welded around it. So now hopefully when I grind that all off, it'll all look nice and tidy once I clean that up. It's not something I've ever thought of doing, but it makes sense because, you know, like you do the same thing with a TIG. Or a stick, you know, you're doing the same thing with the MIG too, you know, but you're just adding a little bit extra metal in there at the same time as a filler rod just to help bridge a slightly bigger gap, or if you blow a hole, it's not a bad idea just to, you can put a little metal coat and hanger in there and just help bridge that gap so you're not blowing metal away willy nilly, you actually can successfully build it up. So it's not a bad little tip. So I'll weld that join up now where I've cut and finished welding that, just that little piece near there now, because I left that until I cut that so I could knock it down a little. And that'll be right. And then I'll weld these holes up because it's meant to be a windscreen washer foot pump in here. But I'll put a little electric motor and then I'll just put a push button on the dash, because the dash has actually had quite a few holes put in it that I've got to weld up anyway, so I'll find a couple of nice little button that I can put in there that'll suit, and I'll just make that the windscreen washer button instead of the old foot plunger that used to be on the floor. So I'll tidy those holes up too. Oh, this one here must be the dip switch, I think. So I'll leave them. So yeah, apart from that, we're not far away from a clean-up, and then I'll tidy up underneath and just double-check and grind everything off flush and clean it all up. And that's the flooring. So that's good. It's nice and solid. And just doesn't look like the other piece did, just sort of piece sort of tacked in there. Like, it was going to be plenty strong enough, being close to 2mm thick, but it just didn't look nice. Now, by the time I got this cleaned up and grind up and fix these few welds and tidy some of these other bits up and pieces underneath, it's not going to matter so much on the inside. It's the underneath, when you're seeing it underneath and people underneath the car and all that sort of stuff. I know part of it's going to be hidden with the subframe, but I just want it to make it look right. That's my big thing. So we'll get back to it and we'll catch you later. Cheers.